Quick, more points. One for you, Clarissa. What is the impact of the 2014 sanctions in response to what Russia did and, of course, denied in the eastern part of Ukraine? How harsh are those sanctions on the people there?
The sanctions are pretty harsh, but it's more the European sanctions that have had a real impact because, of course, Europe is a much bigger trading partner with Russia than the U.S. has. The ruble depreciated considerably. You see Russians obviously traveling less. You can't get cheese here, if you can believe that, because of all the imports that are no longer allowed here. It has definitely had a substantial effect on the price of living here, the cost of living, and the quality of life. What it has not had an effect on is Russian aggression or Russian behavior on the world stage. As we have seen in Crimea, in Syria, it's business as usual for the Kremlin, Chris.
All right, now let's switch to China. David, there's a stark difference in how our president-elect ignores Russia but has decided to emphasize what China has been doing. We'll put up the tweets just to remind our audience here. He has been silent about Putin's reactions. There's been nothing there, but with China, we should tell China that we don't want the drone they stole back. Let them keep it. China steals United States Navy research drone in international waters, rips it out of the water, and takes it to China. Unprecedented act. What is the relative leverage in this situation in taking the Chinese on head on?
That's a good question because, you know, look, China has so much of the U.S.'s debt right now. And one of the you know, interesting quotes is, you know, if you owe someone, you know, $1 billion, they own you. If you owe someone $5 billion, you own them. We actually have a lot of leverage over China. And part of Trump's view with respect to China is that the U.S. has been getting a raw deal in terms of trade with China. He has a number of different other grievances, including Chinese policy towards North Korea and the like. And so it's going to be interesting to see how it shapes up. Ultimately, he probably wants to divide Russia from China, cast them against each other. But with Trump, it's always a question of whether he has direct steps to getting to what his ultimate vision is.
That is an interesting little bit of intrigue you threw in there. Is Trump positioning Russia to be an ally against China? We'll have to see if that's thinking or just convenience at this point. David, thank you very much. Clarissa, we let go. She's in Moscow. Thanks to both of you. Alice.